Hello, Year 9, and welcome to our next lesson in the electrical circuits topic. Today we're going to look at resistors. We're going to have a bit of an introduction to resistors, what they are, how they're used, and then next lesson we'll come on to some of the rules around resistors in circuits. Okay, so your starter questions are here. Hopefully you've seen them already. So pause the video if you've not done these already and have a go. Okay, so your teacher will go through the answers for these. Let's get started. So, introduction to resistors first of all. So resistors are components that are designed to limit the flow of current in a circuit. We know that they increase or decrease the resistance, so they can allow current to flow more easily, or they can reduce the amount of current. Okay, and they respond to changes in surroundings. So they either respond to a change in the current itself. So if the current, in terms of normal fixed resistors, lamps, diodes, those kind of things, okay, so they will, the resistance will change depending on the amount of current that is flowing through them. There are other types of resistors, thermistors and LDRs, light dependent resistors, which are reliant on the surrounding conditions. So thermistors, as the name suggests, respond to changes in temperature. Okay, and LDRs, light dependent resistors, respond to changes in the light that is being shone, the amount of light that they receive. We'll come on to those in more detail in future lessons. So some resistors are what we call ohmic conductors, O-H-M-I-C. So we'll know the term ohms already from resistors, from resistance as being the unit for resistance, ohms. So ohmic conductors mean that the current through the resistor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the resistor. So that's when that's at a constant temperature. So therefore, what that means is the resistance is constant through that component. So as we increase the potential difference, okay, the current is directly proportional to that. So the current will increase at the same amount. Other resistors are said to be non-ohmic conductors. So as current increases, so does resistance. Okay, and we're going to look at that in a little bit more detail now. They're the ones we're really interested in. So let's look at some uses first of all. So resistors are found in circuits, as I've said, to control the current that flows through it. One type are filament lamps, so normal bulbs that we have in our homes. Okay, these are not the energy saving ones so much, but the ones that have the old style that have a filament in them. What happens with those bulbs is that as they the current is traveling through them, their resistance increases. Okay, so the resistance in there increases, which means that they heat up and they start to emit heat. Diodes are another type of resistor which only allow current to flow in one direction. So in the opposite direction, it has a very high resistance. And we're going to look at an example of that in a moment. As I've mentioned, thermistors are used in circuits where perhaps temperature control is required, so such as the thermostat in your central heating system. So as the temperature of the thermistor increases, resistance might decrease, okay, to reduce the temperature. And then light-dependent resistors are useful where we want automatic light control or light detection. So for example, security lights or in the camera in your phone. So the resistance of an LDR decreases as light intensity increases. So how would we investigate these resistors? Well, this is a typical circuit that we would need to do. Oh, sorry, don't quite know what's happened there. Let's put that back, there we go. So this is a typical circuit, okay, that we would want to look at in order to investigate a resistor in a circuit. So you can see we've got a number of things here. Okay, so we have an ammeter, we have a in series, as we know. So here's our ammeter. Okay, we then have our battery or our cell in our circuit. Here's our fixed resistor. Okay, so this is our resistor. And remember, we have our voltmeter measuring the potential difference across that resistor. And then we have here a variable resistor. Okay. Now, the use of the variable resistor, okay, is in order to control the amount of current that's going through here. Okay, so we want to be able to control, and if we want to investigate this, we want to be able to change the readings that we get. Okay, so we remember we use an ammeter to measure current in amps. And we use a voltmeter to measure potential difference in volts. Okay. And in order to get a series of data from the resistor, so to work out some values of resistance across this resistor, okay, we would vary the the variable resistor. We've changed the settings on the adjust the variable resistor to get current and potential different readings, which we would then use our equation to calculate resistance. Okay, now what we'd also want to be interested in, because at the moment current is just flowing one way, okay, we'd also be interested to know what happens when current flows the other way. Okay, so to do that, all we would need to do is swap round the connection terminals. Sorry, not here. Swap round the connection terminals at the battery. Okay, so we would change these wires round and put the wire here into the other side of the battery and this wire into this side of the battery, and that would allow the current to flow the opposite direction. So there's some key points there. Okay, now what I want you to do is to answer these questions based on what I've just talked through. Okay, so if you're not sure, you can go back and rewatch the video, but pause the video now and have a go at answering these three questions in full sentences, please. Okay, how did you get on? So these are your answers, so check what you wrote. Okay, now these are some examples of the types of graphs that we would get when we look at these three resistors that I've talked about. Okay, so here on the top left is our fixed resistor, first of all. Okay, and I want you to look carefully at what you can see, okay, with our current. So here, remember, the reason we've got a graph that looks like this is these are our positive values and these are our positive values. Down here are our negative values and negative values. So sometimes we might see on an ammeter or a voltmeter negative values and we think, oh, it's round the wrong way. So this is important information. Okay. Now what we remember what we said was that here, okay, this is directly proportional. Okay, directly proportional. Because as you can see, as we increase voltage, current increases by the same amount. As we decrease voltage, current decreases by the same amount. Okay, so this is what we call an ohmic conductor. Okay, this is an ohmic conductor. Now I want you to compare that with our filament lamp. So in our filament lamp, you'll notice it's not the same graph. Okay, there is a point at which, as we increase voltage, current doesn't increase by the same amount. Okay, so this point here. And equally in the opposite direction, it's so this is a non-ohmic conductor. It doesn't follow the rules, doesn't follow Ohm's law. Okay. And the reason for this is because, as we've already mentioned, that as we run current through a lamp, the lamp heats up. Okay, so at this point here, okay, it is heating up. Because current is, so therefore resistance is increasing. Resistance is not constant, okay? Now let's look at the diode. Now remember the diode, we said, works in one direction only. It only allows current to flow in one direction. So here's our positive, here's the current flowing in one direction, okay? You'll notice that it takes a little bit of voltage for that to happen, and then the current is consistent. It increases by at the same amount, okay? However, if we switch the cables around and try and run current in the opposite direction, there is no flow of current. Okay, no flow of current. So again, this is non-ohmic. So I just want you to pay attention to these and look at these graphs in some detail, okay? And understand the differences, first of all, between these three types of resistor. Okay, so your task is some practice questions which are provided on the practice panel on the Padlet. Okay, so I'd like you, that's your task during this lesson, is to complete those, and then for your teacher will review them at the end. Okay, so when you come back together, you'll go through those questions together. Okay, that's it for this video. I look forward to seeing you next time.